God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors, he parted the raging seas. My God, he holds a victory. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet. We will shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. And we won't be quiet. We will shout out your praise. Oh, oh, oh. We'll shout out your praise. To the God who heals, we sing to the God who saves, we sing to the God who always makes a way. 'Cause he hung up on that cross and he rose up from that grave. My God, still rolling stones away. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet. We will shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. And we won't be quiet. We will shout out your praise. Oh, oh, oh. We'll shout out your praise. Oh, oh, oh. 'Cause we were the beggars, and now we're royalty. And we were the prisoners, and now we're running free. We were forgiven, indebted, redeemed by his grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. We are the beggars, and now we're royalty. And we were the prisoners, and now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by his grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet. We will shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. My God is surely in this place. Redeemed us, that we are of royal priesthood, that you deem us to be righteous. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord, for who you are, for who you are, and not just what you do for us, for who you are. You are worthy, you are holy, you are righteous, and you deserve all our praises and glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. was my cross you bore, so I could live in the freedom you died for. And now my life is yours, and I will sing of your goodness forevermore. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name. Glory fills His place. You alone deserve our praise. You're the name above all names. Be exalted now in the heavens as Your glory fills His place. You alone deserve our praise. You're the name above all names. Be exalted now in the heavens as Your glory. Praise, You're the name above all names. praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. One more. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name.
Worthy is your name, Christ Jesus. Worthy, worthy, worthy. Your word says, glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those who his favor rests. Peace to those who his favors rest. Does his favor rest on you? You have a decision to make. It's your will. Align it with Father God. Align it. Pastor Dorcas, please.
As we were praying, God just put this Isaiah 61 on our hearts as we go out. If you have your Bible, please get ready. What I'm going to do is read it through. And then I feel that we should declare it as a church over ourselves. When Jesus started his ministry, this is what he shared before he went out, you know, to go and continue to be a light to everyone at the beginning of his ministry. In fact, in Isaiah, some people think Isaiah is like the fifth gospel. There's so much about what Jesus came to do, and he confirmed that over and over again. He quoted a lot from this scripture. So are you ready? If you've got your Bible or your smartphone like me with your Bible on there, Isaiah 61, I'm reading from the NIV. It says, the Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness for the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn and provide for those who grieve in Zion, to bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of joy instead of a spirit of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of a spirit of despair. They will be called oaks of righteousness, a planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor. And they will rebuild the ancient ruins and restore the places long devastated. They will renew the ruined cities that have been devastated for generations. So let's go back again. The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted and to proclaim freedom for the captives. Amen. That's you and me, all of us already anointed. As we go out today and share our lives, God has already anointed us. It's in us, whether we realize it or not, we've been anointed. And there's a lot of brokenness in our nation right now. God has anointed you and me to come and bring comfort and release and freedom to the captives. People are bound. They need Jesus to free them up. That's you and me. You and I are the answers. We're anointed. We are God carriers. We're spirit carriers of the living God, life carriers, light, carriers of light. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Pastor Dorcas, because those verses hold our identity, guys. The world shows us so many different things and so many lies, yeah? But the word of God is who we are.
Manifest yourself. manifest himself. Just the voice is Yahweh.
Just ponder in his presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
And realize who he is.
Yes, Lord. You're welcome.
And what he's made us. Let us just ponder. Anthony, I'd like you to share the words you've just said to me.
Just as we were singing that song, I was reminded that the Lord isn't just filling this place as in a church building, but we are the temples of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, yeah.
He's doing something great in your heart, in your life. And I want you to claim that today, yes, that actually his glory wants to fill you, to manifest his presence,
amen,
in all of your life, to go out to the streets, to your neighbors, to all the people so that they could encounter his presence. So
amen.
His glory is filling you. His
yes,
glory
Jesus.
Is filling you. His glory is
Thank
filling
you.
Our lives. Not just this place, but your place, your heart, the place where he dwells, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord.
Just spend time reflecting on that. He has anointed us. He's anointed you personally for something truly special. Thank you, Lord.
If the altar's where you need us, take me there, take me there. If what you need is just an offering, it's right here, my life is here, and I'll be a living sacrifice for you. You're a fire, I wanna be consumed. I wanna be tried by fire. Purified, you take whatever you desire. Lord, here's my life. I wanna be tried by fire. Purified, you take whatever you desire. Lord, here's my life. If your glory wants to come here, let it fall. We want it all. Your fire is consuming. Fill this place, set it ablaze, and I'll be a living sacrifice for you. You're a fire, the refiner. I wanna be consumed. I wanna be tried by fire. Purified, you take whatever you take one. So clean my hands and purify my heart. I wanna burn for you, only for you. So take my life as a sacrifice. I wanna burn for you, only for you. So clean my hands, purify. Refiner, I wanna be consumed. You're the fire, the refiner. I wanna be consumed. You're the fire, the refiner. I wanna be consumed. I wanna be tried by fire. Purified, you take whatever you desire. Lord, here's my life. I wanna be tried by fire. Purified, you take whatever you desire. Lord, here's my life. You take whatever you desire. Lord, here's my life. You take whatever you desire. Lord, here's my life.
Worship team, we're going to sing that verse again. But before we do, I just want to say John 3:16. You know, so God loved the world and he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish. Shall not perish. We choose to believe these words. Faith, please come up and share what you shared to me, with me.
Yeah, when we were worshiping, I also just felt God placing my heart, John 3:16. So I'm just going to say it again and speak it over us as a church. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn or judge the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of God's one and only son. I just felt God wanting to remind us of the woman in the Bible who committed adultery, and the Pharisees brought her forward before Jesus in the temple courts, and they said, by the law of Moses, she should be stoned. And Jesus took his time and looked them in the eye and said to them, whoever is without sin, cast the first stone. And one by one, the Pharisees walked away and left. And Jesus said to the woman, do I condemn you? And she said, no. And he said, okay, you're not condemned. Now go away and sin no more. I just felt God wanting to remind us of Romans 8, verse 1. There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. And he says, that's because of my love. My love trumps it. And I felt God wanting to remind us of the end of the chapter where it talks about the fact that there's nothing that can separate us from the love of God. There's literally nothing that can separate us from the love of God. No height, no depth, not death, nor life. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. And he says, remember, I love you. You're my children. It's about my love. I'm your father and you're my children. That's why I died for you. And John 14, verse 23, he says, if you love me, you'll keep my commands. You'll keep my teaching. It's a relationship. And my peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. And I do not give as the world does.
Amen. Remember, church, having courage is not feeling fear. It's feeling fear, but still doing the right thing.
So clean my hands and purify my heart. I want to burn for you, only for you. And take my life as a sacrifice. I want to burn for you, only for you. So clean my hands and purify.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.